He says he was just looking for love, so he paid his money and ordered up a wife from Russia. It's what happened next that brought the News 8 investigators into the story.
It's happening all over the country. American men looking for mail-order brides from other countries.
Many come from Russia. They are women looking for a better life here in the U.S. But one San Diego man says he got a lot more than he bargained for. News 8 investigator Kevin Cox is here now with more on this story. Kevin.
A grandma Denise, this is how Carlos Villarroel found his Russian bride. It's a catalog full of brides, actually two of them. Many foreign women search for husbands this way, and plenty of American men are willing to marry them. Is it old-fashioned matchmaking or just a sneaky way to get around immigration laws? And we can only tell you what happened to Carlos. There are thousands and thousands of them. Beautiful, intelligent, from countries all over the world. With all these women, how did this man, Carlos Villarroel, decide on his future wife?
I don't know. I say probably this one is very good.
This one is Yelena Chakoskina, a 42-year-old from Russia. Carlos sent in his $10 to get her address. Soon he went to meet her in Moscow.
Sweet, beautiful. Sex almost every day.
They got married in Moscow on one of his three visits to Russia. He paid for airline tickets, hotels, food. He bought gifts, jewelry, clothes. He says he bought everything, including the story that Yelena was coming to America to be his wife. But it didn't last. She left Carlos and his mobile home. Next thing he knows, she's living her new life in America with her new boyfriend. So now, Carlos is not only brokenhearted, he feels cheated. All his gifts, the trips to Moscow, all of it. He says he spent more than $20,000 on a wife who lied about her love to get to paradise.
Because she used me. She used me for come to America, very clear.
My husband and I were very different people, absolutely different. But we did not know about before marriage. I hope have happiness and he hope have happiness.
But for Carlos, happiness would be getting Yelena kicked out of the country for fraud. He heads to the INS to file a complaint.
I know she is very bad person, and this moment is very bad person.
Did she break the law? Immigration won't jump to conclusions.
And we take all factors into account. Every case is different.
She seems not bad person, good man.
But apparently not as good as this man. Meet Steve Snyder, Yelena's new boyfriend.
Spousal support ordered it.
This is divorce court, the end of the line for the marriage of Carlos and Yelena. Outside the courtroom, Steve tells me another side of the story.
There was no even drives around San Diego to, you know, visit the area, to do things, to show her the local sights at all. He was looking for a captive is what it amounts to.
But Carlos shows us these pictures. Yelena at Ocean Beach, at Mission Bay, at Balboa Park, at the Wild Animal Park, at the zoo, at La Jolla, even sitting in a fire engine. But Steve has another complaint. Carlos lied about his age, saying he was only 48.
She discovered he was in fact 67 years old.
Is that too old to be a husband?
No, it was too old when she found out that the man requires injections to have sex.
Steve claims that Carlos could not function as a proper husband, not without a little help. So why did she marry him?
That was not made clear to Yelena in Russia?
Not until after they were married.
I don't need pills, I don't need shots, I don't need nothing. I do the sex.
You did?
She's very happy and she wanted to marry me.
And the law says she needed to stay married to him for 2 years. She made it 23 months.
A situation like this may raise some red flags with the Immigration and Naturalization Service.
Jim Pilkington is a criminal investigator with immigration. He says the law has exceptions to the two-year rule for women who have been battered or subjected to extreme cruelty. But there's a catch.
We require documentation or evidence of alleged abuses or cruelty, these types of things.
Yelena's lawyer says she never accused Carlos of abuse. Documents show age, cultural, and economic issues as the cause for the divorce.
And I called many times for immigration.
And so when his husband says that he called, were his calls ignored?
We don't ignore calls. Every call we get is documented.
But so. Jim Pilkington says the INS is busy tracking down these guys, the ones they call criminal aliens. Investigating Yelena Chacoscana just doesn't rank.
Here in San Diego, we have a very good handle on marriage fraud.
Even if you don't get to everybody right away.
Right. It's just a matter of time.
And while Carlos waits for immigration to catch up with his ex-wife, he's thinking about catching up with his next wife.
No, not sure. Not exactly. I can try first in America.
But he still has the catalogs, just in case.
Yes, the magazine have all the time. Business have all the time.
Chacoscana's attorney tells me she's very hopeful that Yelena will be able to convince immigration to let her stay in the U.S. It will be one more interesting chapter in the story of Carlos and Yelena. If you have a story idea for the investigators, please give us a call at our confidential hotline. There's the number on the screen.